So, do you know about corporate bonds? Corporate bonds make people money, and this is a sector that has been a bit dead in Kenya for a while now. But right now, corporate bonds are back, and you can get really good returns on investment if you know what to do and if you know which kinds of bonds to actually invest in. So, in this video, we're going to talk about the family bank bonds, which is giving people amazing returns. And family bank has been very stable financially speaking. And their bonds are even now trading at the NSE, and we'll talk about all that. So in this video, we're just going to look at corporate bonds in general, and then we'll focus on the family bank bonds that were offered recently and that I'm sure will be offered in the near future, and the ones trading at NSE that you can still buy in the secondary market. And then we will talk about the advantages of investing in corporate bonds and the returns that you can get from corporate bonds and how they pay you. So stay tuned. And here we talk about the money mindset, how to make that money, how to manage that money, how to enjoy that money, how to invest that money, and how to assure yourself of a lifetime of income, basically financial freedom. So one of the things that can actually give you financial freedom is corporate bonds. And in Kenya, corporate bonds have been a bit risky because corporate bonds are offered by the company. So before I go there, let me just tell you what are corporate bonds. Corporate bonds are basically debt securities, whereby a company is asking you for money, asking investors for money because they want to do so many things. There are things that they want to do, and therefore they need cash. So they come to the public and they ask you for money, just the same way government comes to the public and asks for money through treasury bonds and treasury bills. So with corporate bonds, it's the company or the organization looking for money. They could be looking for money for mergers and acquisitions, for expansion, just to, strengthen their capital base. Basically, for so many reasons, a company would require money, and therefore they offer these bonds in return for some fixed term or even variable interest rates that will be paid to the investor. So if I buy a corporate bond, for example, with a family bank, and they will tell me, okay, you have bought 100,000 worth of corporate bond, we're going to fix this money, use this money for the next 5.5 years or 5 years, and within that time, we're going to give you back money after every set period of time. So they'll be paying you your principal amount of money, will be paying you money after every set period of time. It could be 6 months. Every 6 months, they pay you 13% of the money. The return is usually fixed, or sometimes it's variable. But like the one that with the family bank is fixed. And I like it fixed sometimes because even if there are fluctuations in the interest market and the environment isn't as good, you will still get your money. So that is a determined cash flow. And I always talk about cash flow. It's very important if you're building a wholesome portfolio to have some bonds in there. And in Kenya, I do not understand why some people are so focused on the stock market while you have the option of having like corporate bonds that could give you very stable fixed income and you're sure about it. Of course, it's risky because the company could go down. Chase Bank went down, and therefore the bonds became junk bonds basically, and just a waste. These are risks we take. The moment you're even investing in a stock, remember you're also taking much more risks with the fluctuations of the company stocks. So it would be even safer to take a corporate bond because even if there are issues with the stocks of the company, you would find that their bonds still remain at the same stage and you still continue getting paid. These things are all different risk levels, and it depends on your risk appetite. So corporate bonds are really good investments, and that's why I want to make this video to just tell you about them, tell you about Family Bank corporate bonds, and tell you how you can get corporate bonds and invest in them from now. So I've told you what corporate bonds are. I've told you why companies can sometimes require money from the public in terms of short-term debt securities or long-term debt securities. In the case of Family Bank, it was a medium-term debt security, medium-term note. That's what we refer to it as, medium-term note. So basically, last month, Family Bank offered in the market corporate bonds worth 3 billion. They were targeting to raise 3 billion Kenya shillings from in subscribers to this particular bond. So subscribers could be banks, financial institutions, insurance companies, pension schemes, and individuals like us or like you. So in that case, it was targeting to raise 3 billion from the market. I think that target was because the market generally has been very cold towards corporate bonds because of the, you know, the state of the nation economically and what happened in some banks in Kenya and stuff like that. So people fear risk, but the funny thing, they fear risk, but they still go into the stock market. So it beats the logic. Actually, it would be easier to go into bond market. So yes, Family Bank was raising $3 billion through the corporate bonds, the bonds that it offered. And the interest rates for these bonds was sitting at 13% fixed income for the next 5 years. So you were supposed to give your money to Family Bank for 5 years, and you'll be getting an interest rate annually of 13%, and that money will be paid to you. That is clean cash flow. If you want cash flow, that is one way you can have cash flow, because it will be, maybe you have different corporate bonds, maybe you also mix it up with some T-bills, you mix it up with some treasury bonds, and you mix it up with some stocks, so you have a very balanced portfolio. So for those who always want to offset some risk from the stock market, it's always good to go into the corporate bond market. So Family Bank raised way more. The subscription for this particular bond was way more than the target. So they ended up raising 4.4 billion Kenya shillings. So usually the Capital Markets Authority allows you to have what we call the greenshoe option. Greenshoe option is whereby you can allot more than you actually wanted to initially. So if there is oversubscription or too much interest, then you can give more, or you can raise more money. It's a very simple process, basically. So instead of the 3 billion, they actually raised 4.4 billion. Oversubscription of 147%. That tells you how much people are interested in investing. People are investing in these particular bonds. But the sad part is that most of them are foreigners in Kenya, if they're individual investors. And if they're institutional investors, then they're the same people you give your money to keep for you at very low interest rates. They go and buy these corporate bonds, they take the risk for you, and then come back and give you that money. So why not just buy the bond yourself? That's where financial literacy comes in. So corporate bonds give people very consistent returns. And most of these banks where you keep your money and they give you 2%, 3%, 4%, these are the kind of things they invest into. Those pension schemes and all those insurance companies that are giving you like 7% at most, this is where they get their money from. So if you have the option and the direct channel to go and buy that corporate bond, then why not? So like I said, Family Bank is raising that money for different reasons. It said it wants to expand its operation capital, it wants to expand its branches across the country, it wants to, you know, have a stronger foundation financially speaking, and they're just basically trying to grow and do certain things that requires money, and that's why they are raising this kind of money. And it's good to mention that in just 2021, this year, 19th of April, they redeemed their 5-year bond that was given some time back, 5 years ago, basically. So there are people who invested in corporate bonds with Family Bank 5 years back, and that was redeemed in April this year. So those people got back their principal amount of money, and they have been getting payment for the last 5 years. So imagine if you have like 5 million, 3 million, 1 million invested in the corporate bond. So you are constantly getting paid with very good amount of money until April. And then they give you back your principal amount of money. So if you were to reinvest everything you got, you would get a really good amount of money. So yes, they redeemed it successfully. Everyone got back their invested principal. All subscription was over 2 billion Kenya shillings. So that tells you again that people are investing in these things, and if you are missing out, you need to start investing as soon as possible. So what is the minimum subscription you require for this bond? It's 100,000 Kenya shillings. So for you to invest in this bond, you will require a minimum of 100,000 shillings, and then subsequently multiples of 100,000 Kenya shillings. So if you have 100,000 shillings, 200,000 shillings, 300,000 shillings, that's how it goes. So yes, it requires a minimum of 100,000 shillings to start investing here. But if you don't have that money, Family Bank bonds are now trading at the Nairobi Stock Exchange. And this was launched just a few days ago. Now they are on the secondary market. It means if you are not able to access the primary market, you can still trade them in the secondary market. And this is something that your broker can help you with. The process is very simple, but it's not something you want to do if you have no information. So it's not locked completely. If you still want to buy it, you still want to trade it, if you still want to purchase this particular bonds from Family Bank, you can still check them out on the Nairobi Stock Exchange listing. So it's now listed under the Fixed Income Security Exchanges at the NSE. So I just wanted to make this video to tell you that the corporate market is good. It's giving consistent good returns. The risk level is quite low, and therefore you should start investing in the corporate bond market. What are you waiting for? You're getting 13%. The last one that they just redeemed was 13.75% for the fixed ones, and for the mixed term notes was 14%, and some T-bills and coupons. So basically, we're looking at something in the range of 13 to 14% from corporate bonds, and you're only giving your money for 5 years, and you're getting paid consistently. So here, there are so many advantages. There's the cash flow, there's the reduced risk, then there's accessibility, then there's the certainty of getting the money, the security of getting money. So basically, you are safe with this thing. You are in a good position to start investing as soon as possible with corporate bonds. And Family Bank is just an example. There are other corporate bonds in Kenya, but I will always tell you, I'm here for you. So guys, for those who are returning, I appreciate you being here. I appreciate the growth. I appreciate the subscription. I appreciate the comments. I appreciate the likes. Please like the video, guys, and subscribe to the channel. We are targeting 100,000 end of next year. Big goal. 10,000 end of this year, another big goal. And we're going to get there. Just support me, and I will also give you the best content to help you grow financially. Thank you, and smash the like button. See you in our next video.